This episode of Leupold's Pigman The Series is brought to you by Leupold, America's optics authority.
Ready, Juve. Must be a good gun. Even you can hit something with it.
Did you ever have a doubt?
Yeah, I was concerned. I'm feeling better now.
I sanded my trigger finger, Juve.
Oh, boy.
So I had some feeling in it.
That's what I'm talking about.
Good equipment, good ammo. That's exactly what happens. And now the pigs better get real low and stay in some brush.
He pops his head out this morning. I got him a little suit performance from Hornady. He ain't gonna like the outcome.
We sat there, and I mean, I could feel the cold coming up from the ground. 9 degrees from Texas. I'm not used to that, man.
I forgot my rangefinder, my Leupold rangefinder. So finally, when we did see a pig, he's kind of got a little old limp, and he's out there a good ways on this fence line running. Of course, I don't have a range, so I'm having to guess it. I'm thinking 250, 300.
You ready?
Yes.
That's what you call four clean misses. Oh, the pig's gonna love that. I don't think it was a hot one. I think it was Keith. Well, had a little malfunction this morning out here. So, I gotta put the pig nose on so I can be a jig like the pig man. Because everybody loves the pig man. I'm the pig man. Everybody loves the pig man. You know that? I'll give you my autograph, because I'm the pig man. Well, I'm not the pig man.
Hello.
I need to speak to Keith.
You got him.
Hey, man, how in the hell do you expect us to keep Leupold as a sponsor with you pulling like that? I mean, seriously, that pig was close to 300 pounds.
Really? No, he wasn't.
Well, it don't matter. Even if he was 200, you missed the entire pig 4 shots.
Got one of the finest rifles, scopes, and the best ammo made. Pow, 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 pow. He needs a machine gun. He can't hit nothing. We wasting time. He ain't done nothing but miss and give me a bunch of crap. But time for pig to show him how to lay it down.
Get to a place, you're pumped, you're excited, you're wanting to get in the field, but guys, girls, you've got to check your equipment, and that's exactly what I intended to do, and that's what I did, and games are about to begin.
It's time to rock.
You hear him?
Brrr.
double up. I seen the blood fly. I got a Charlie horse in my right foot. My knees blowed out. That's a stag we've been after.
You made a tragic mistake. He did not realize I had a vendetta by Leupold mounted on my hoy. Because when he stepped in the road, he got shanked.
Right here, man. That's the difference. Had I arranged and hurt, I wouldn't have had time to shoot him.
So what happened? Did he come down this way?
Yeah, Matt saw him before I did, but then he came to right here, and luckily I picked up on your professional calling skills. He came right here, and with this vendetta, I hit this tree and that tree at full draw before he come across the road. Did I get it? Wake up! What the hell's wrong with you, man? I thought you New Zealanders, you Kiwis, could see through the trees.
So where is he?
Well, he crossed right here between these two trees, and he took off that way. But when he took off running, I seen the blood flying out of him.
You know, I'm constantly seems like I'm bashing these Kiwis. They're great guys. One good thing about them, Ken, he's got the right kind of scope. He's got a Leupold scope on a gun, and we got some Hornady 708 ammo. And I'm thinking, you know what? Let's do some long range. If we can set up and try to get on a goat and make a long range shot, that's kind of my plan. And I thought I had seen everything. Well, you've heard of big green tractor? Negative. Not in the Kiwi land. Not in New Zealand. It's my raggedy red Italian tractor. We are in wherever, somewhere in New Zealand on a river in two jet boats at another remote camp. And we have a hunting rig over here that's attached behind a tractor.
Leupold may save the day, after all.
Here's what we got in, and Matt spotted this big billy right up on the side of this hill.
Yeah, on the side of the hill. We can't get near him, the cows are spooking. We'll sneak over here. We've got a river in our way. We'll give this thing a test, eh?
332. It's a long shot for a 708, but Leupold scopes, baby. Look at that stick right there. I'm going to get right here. Got him.
Shot. Great shot.
Hornady, baby. Accurate, deadly, dependable. See what I'm telling you? We have rowed in an airboat for 40 miles. Is that what you call a jet boat? We have jumped rocks. And this scope, look at the marks. Now, Ian, swim the creek and pack my goat out.
Hey, can you hold my coat while I swim it?
Yeah, not a problem, mate. Can't say enough about the operation. Luckily, old Ken had a Leupold scope on that gun and made it work. Appreciate it, as always. It's been an adventure.
Yeah, we got a pretty good trip set up. You know, we got Tom Fricktail from Leupold and his son Joe Fricktail, which works for Benchmate Knives. We got these guys coming in. They've been wanting to hunt for a long time.
President and CEO Leupold's coming down to hunt with us. No pressure at all, Big Brian. But here we are. We're going to try to put them on some pigs, and we're going to give them little dogs on hogs, actually.
We're going to try to get them guys on some nice pigs. Pigman's going to be doing a little guiding. I'm going to be doing a little guiding, and we don't have to run the camera, so that's perfect for me.
I wanted them to come in a little bit earlier. July is very, very hot at my place, and you figure it out real quick. When they step off the plane, they're ready to board again and get out of there, and they're like, oh, man, what's the deal? But look, we're going to be on pigs no matter what the temperature. That's the way we do it. We've been prepping for them for a couple of weeks, them coming in. Tom's going to hunt with a pistol. Joe's going to hunt with a bow.
Old Joe's never shot anything with his bow, not a pig anyway, so he's going to be in for a rude awakening, and I'm excited to see how he does because these pigs are tough. He'll find that out.
You have to have adequate equipment to stop these pigs when thing turns bad. 99 times out of 100, they may not, but that one time they do, you need to have the right equipment. We're actually going to be doing some testing. What better way to do it? With Tom, the man that makes the stuff. You know, he calls the shots, he makes the final decisions on the products, and we're about to see how they work.
We got two new products that I'm going to talk about. You guys have already seen me using the Vendetta bow-mounted range finder on my bows. No bow that I have will be without one of those things. This is the new Delta Point. This is a completely new sight. You can mount it on just about anything, and I can assure you, if it'll take the recoil of this 4570, it'll handle anything. So I'm gonna let Tom tell you a little bit about that Delta Point.
Well, this is a new product that we introduced this year, and it comes with two different aiming points. You can have a triangle aiming point or a dot aiming point, and it makes an average pistol shooter like myself a pretty good pistol shooter. The great thing about this product, it weighs just a shade over a half an ounce. You can mount it up. It comes with 13 different mount applications in with the Delta Point, and it really gives you a fantastic sight picture. And like the Pigman says, if it can take the recoil of a Magnum Research BFR 4570 caliber revolver, that's all you need to know. It's a very durable product and backed with a standard Leupold warranty.
Tom was basically cutting the same holes with the shots. He's a great pistol shot. You know, mission number two, and was very important to Tom, of course, is to take care of baby boy Joe. He's pretty handy with them Benchmate knives. He's actually impressing me a little bit with his shooting abilities, but he's never killed an animal.
Oh, I see you've been watching my show quite regularly.
Bang, look at that. Didn't take Joe very long. He had that Vendetta dialed right in. Joe mounted it himself. He was shooting awesome. Helped him a little bit with his bow form. You know, he appreciated that. That's the way I learned. That's the way I was taught. Pass that on to him. It's awesome to be able to help somebody. And hey, it's time to go hunting.
What else do you want me to say? Do I need to say anything else? I've shot this bow a total of maybe 30 times, and that's what it does. I'm not a target shooter. I'm a paid assassin. That's what I am.
As soon as she steps in the clear, he ain't gonna stop. Watch her stay on her. She's gonna drop. She's down right there. Boom. Down.
Give me some.
Oh, man. Awesome, dude.
Bang, man. I mean, right away we cracked her, and we're standing there, you know, and we're trying to make TV, so we're trying to do the recovery, and I look down the road towards the blind, and there's a javelina between us and the blind. So you know what's about to happen.
God almighty. Somebody better take this damn hoid out of my hand.
You can't even get in the blind, man. You got two kills.
Vendetta calls her 55, Jim. And I said, well, I wonder what the old alpha burner will do. Wham! 12 ringed javelina at 55 yards. And we're on a multiple species killing fest.
And yeah, I'm jumping up and down on the Ranger having a good time. Old Big Man done this. That's what you get, man. That's my karma.
That would have been a one-shot kill had I took the time to pushed the button on the Vendetta and used it. That's what it's for. You hear me bragging about it, shame on me for not doing it and not using it, but I will be doing from now on. That is a good lesson.